Hello again. Thank you for tuning in to episode 2.4 of our video series Parallel Programming and Optimization with Intel Xeon Phi Coprocessors. In this video, we will discuss software tools needed and recommended for developing applications for Intel Xeon Phi Coprocessors. We will begin with software that is necessary to boot coprocessors and to run precompiled executables on them. First and foremost, you must have MPSS, the many-core platform software stack, running in order to use your coprocessors. The MPSS daemon is responsible for loading the operating system image onto the coprocessors at boot, creating the virtual network and assigning IP addresses to the coprocessors, and for enabling communication between host applications and the coprocessors. MPSS also contains a variety of utilities for system administration and diagnostics, which we'll discuss shortly. The latest version of MPSS can be downloaded for free from the Intel website. Now let's take a look at some of the utilities that MPSS offers. Micinfo is a command line tool that displays general information about your system and coprocessors, like model number, core count, and MPSS version. Micsmc is a system monitoring tool that comes with a graphical user interface. It allows you to see the timeline of various system metrics such as power usage, memory usage, temperature, and core utilization. micsmc can also display a bar graph of core utilization for each individual core, which is useful for detecting load imbalance. micsmc can also control some of the physical properties of coprocessors, such as power management modes and memory error correction code, or ECC functionality. micctrl is a comprehensive configuration tool for Xeon Phi coprocessors. It simplifies many system administration tasks like managing Linux accounts, network configuration, and services such as network file sharing on coprocessors. Keep in mind that those changes cannot be made while the MPSS is running. You have to first stop the MPSS service using the system control or an equivalent command of your operating system. micctrl can also be used for power control to shut down or reboot coprocessors without rebooting the host system. micckeck runs a set of diagnostic tests to identify potential problems with the system configuration. For instance, it checks the firmware version on coprocessors and verifies network connectivity between the host and coprocessors. It can be used as a sanity check to make sure the Xeon Phi coprocessors are configured correctly. The last two tools are mostly important for system administrators. micrasd is a host daemon logger for hardware errors on coprocessors. micflash is used for flashing the memory agent on Xeon Phi coprocessors. Besides MPSS, in order to run an executable program, you need to have its dependent libraries. Those libraries must be compiled for the mic architecture. Oftentimes, applications for coprocessors use Intel libraries, such as the offload library or the Intel OpenMP library. If you have the Intel Parallel Studio Suite installed, then those libraries are already present on your system. However, users who want to only run precompiled applications for Xeon Phi but do not want to develop applications do not need to install Parallel Studio. They can use redistributable libraries which can be downloaded from the Intel website for free. Finally, if you have an application that uses OpenCL, you need to use Intel OpenCL Runtime and Software Developer Kit or SDK to compile the code for coprocessors. Now let's take a look at the software necessary to build the application that runs on Intel Xeon Phi coprocessors. The primary tool that software developers need is a compiler, Intel C, C++, and Fortran compilers version 13 and up that can build applications for CPUs as well as Xeon Phi coprocessors. To the best of our knowledge, as of today, Intel compilers are the only option for high-performance applications development with Intel Xeon Phi coprocessors in C, C++, and Fortran. Even though there exists a branch of the GNU compiler that can build applications for Xeon Phi, this compiler is only supported for building the Linux distribution for Xeon Phi, and it does not have support for performance-critical optimizations such as automatic virtualization on Xeon Phi coprocessors. In addition to the compiler, Intel offers additional software development tools to assist parallel programmer, not only with coprocessor programming, but also with general-purpose processor programming. Those tools can be licensed separately or can be bundled in a product suite called Intel Parallel Studio XE. Although those tools are not necessary, some users may find them useful, and in this training we'll be talking about some of them. Specifically, our video course will cover two Intel performance optimization tools, VTune and ITAC. Intel VTune Amplifier XE, or VTune Profiler for short, is a performance analysis tool for shared memory parallel applications. It uses performance monitoring units in Intel platforms to collect statistics of hardware events during the execution of your binary executable. It allows the programmer to detect the potential performance bottlenecks of the application down to a single line of code. It also provides general guidance regarding application performance based on statistics of events such as cache misses, data page walks, branch misprediction, vector operation utilization, and others. Another performance optimization tool included in Parallel Studio is ITAC, which stands for Intel Trace Analyzer and Collector. This is a profiling tool specifically for MPI applications. It can be used to visualize communication between MPI processes and help the developer to find issues in communication and load balance across a computing cluster. Besides performance tuning tools, Parallel Studio contains Intel MKL, or Intel Math Kernel Library. Intel MKL is a collection of common mathematical functions, such as linear algebra routines, Fourier transform, random number generators, and others. MKL is deeply optimized both for processors and Intel coprocessors. Relying on MKL can be an easy way to leverage multiple cores, vector registers, and for some functions, multiple compute devices. We'll discuss MKL in a separate episode in this course. Additional software development tools in Parallel Studio, which we are not have the opportunity to discuss in this course, are Intel Inspector, used to troubleshoot memory issues in Parallel applications, and Intel Advisor, a tool that can assist with the implementation of parallelism in your application. As I mentioned earlier, those Intel software development tools are components of a software bundle called Intel Parallel Studio XE. Parallel Studio is available in three flavors: Composer Edition, Professional Edition, and Cluster Edition. You can find more information about those suites and purchase a license at the Intel website.
In the next video, we will talk about designing your parallel application. Thank you for tuning in, and I hope to see you in the next video.